morning, and welcome to Rancho News Network. My name is Diana.
And my name is Morgan. This episode will take a look back onto previous months of news stories, as well as a glimpse into upcoming events around campus.
At the end of this episode, we have an important feature put together by GSA to share with the student body. So let's dive in. Our lead story this episode is our color guard and drumline. The Northern California Band Association Winter Championship were held this past month for indoor drumline and color guard. They hit some milestones that have never before been reached by Rancho Cotate High School.
This season, the Rancho Cotate High School Winter Color Guard had an undefeated season and won the NCBA Triple National A Championship. This division achievement and championship title has not happened at this level for Rancho Cotate in our 16 years of doing winter activities. Color Guard ended their season with an 82.85, a very high score for Color Guard, and 49 high school Color Guard competed at the NCBA Championship.
Furthermore, this season, the RCHS drumline went to four competitions. They took first at San Mateo High School Winter Review, third place at the Antelope High School Winter Review, and first place at the Foothill Winter Review. Then to finish their season, drumline came in second place at the NCBA Championship Review at Rodriguez High School. Drumline finished their season with a score of 84.98, also a high score, in the Regional A division. The drumline will finish their season on April 15th in the Stockton Arena competition in the NCPA circuit. Congratulations to all students involved in both color guard and drumline, and to Mr. Friel for leading the way.
On to our next story. Over spring break, Rancho's first ever robotics team attended a three-day-long worldwide tournament in San Francisco. This was Rancho's first time competing in the first robotics competition, joining the ranks of teams who have been doing this for 20-plus years since first began. They collaborated and strategized with the 40 other teams there to come up with the best game plan for each match.
The team had only 8 weeks to design, build, and program their robot, and their team of 10 was the smallest compared to other teams of up to 120 members. Throughout the competition, their robot broke multiple times, but they were still able to fix it and come back to win a few more matches.
You'll get to see their competing robot during this one's rally. Join Rancho's robotics team to collaborate in the making of a whole new robot that will be competing in next year's competition. If this interests you, contact our team captain, Alex Nava, or Mrs. McWilliams in T203.
Last week, Rancho held its annual egg hunt. Over 1,300 eggs were hidden around campus, and students had the opportunity to put their hunting skills to the test. Eggs contained a wide range of prizes, including candy, trinkets, as well as gift cards and tickets to prom. Thank you to all those involved for putting on this fun event for our student body.
Next, we wanted to give a shout out to Dylan Campbell and his cast and crew in the production of the short film Concerto. Concerto was selected into the Sonoma County Student Film Festival held in March. There were over 50 submissions and only 14 films selected. Out of those 14, Concerto was the only entry from high school level student and competed against film festivals from UC, Santa Cruz, San Francisco State, and Sonoma State. If you want to check out the film, the link is attached in the description below.
Congratulations again to the entire cast and crew. Speaking of film festivals, we are going to send it over to Kat for some upcoming dates of some exciting events.
Good morning, everyone. Rancho Cotate's own film festival is returning this year. On Thursday, May 18th, a selection of advanced filmmaking students' projects will premiere in the TAG Theater and will be judged by a panel of industry professionals. If you love the movies, you won't want to miss this. The film festival will run from 6 to 8 p.m. and we hope to see you in front of the silver screen. And starting next week, Rancho Cotate's Theater Arts is proud to present Mean Girls the Musical, with shows running throughout the weekend. You can catch us at the following dates and times: Thursday, 4:20 at 7 p.m., Friday, 4:21 at 7 p.m., Saturday, 4:22 at 1 p.m. and 7 p.m. Back to you all at the main desk.
Thanks, Kat. Tickets can be purchased for Mean Girls via GoFan or at the door. Good luck to those involved, and we hope to see you there. Now is here Abdul with the Spirit Update.
The current Spirit Point count has sophomores and staff tied in first place, sophomores with 325 points and staff with 400 points. Seniors, juniors, and freshmen are tied in second place with 300 points each. Keep an eye out for our last Spirit Week, which will take place prom week. Back to Morgan and Diana.
We have one final announcement for the RNN schedule. We will be off air for the next few weeks as the advanced film and broadcast class begin their end of the year capstone projects.
We'll be back on air in early May in our usual time slot, and we'll send out a more specific date in the upcoming weeks.
And with the closing words for this episode, we turn it over to GSA, who graciously put together this very important feature for us all. Thank you for tuning in.
Today is the Day of Silence, one of the most important days for the LGBTQIA+ community. But what is this day for? Why does it exist, and how can you contribute?
The Day of Silence is held in remembrance of any and all queer individuals who have been silenced because of homophobia and transphobia within their countries, their cities, and their communities.
On the Day of Silence, most people supporting this day will either remain silent or educate others on the significance of this day. The gravity of staying silent is used to call attention to all the voices of queer people who have been silenced.
An example of the history of queer erasure is present even in our local area. Sonoma County is now considered an accepting community for the LGBTQIA+ community, but it didn't used to be. The Press Democrat states it took 5 years of unsuccessful attempts by queer activists in the late 1980s and early 1990s before Sonoma County supervisors recognized Pride Week.
The same article also includes that the first Pride resolution in the county was presented in May of 1987 to a couple of supervisors, and it wasn't included on their agenda. Supervisors refused to pass it in 1988 and again in 1989 with a 4-1 vote against it.
The University of Virginia in 1996. And the Day of Silence is still held to this day.
As much as many of us wish that silencing of queer voices is a thing of the past, it isn't. Queer people as of 2022 are 10 times more likely to face hate crimes than non-queer people. Restriction and erasure of queer voices is also a very common thing in recent legislation. Being an ally is more than just being kind. It means standing up for queer people to make sure their voices are heard. You need to treat people with respect, including respecting their pronouns and orientations. Respect what someone's name is, even if something like introducing your name and your pronouns. Show others that you are a safe space. If you see someone being disrespectful to a member of the queer community, say something. Let them know that that kind of behavior is not tolerated.
Legislation across the United States is being passed that limits and destroys queer voices. One Florida bill, Bill 999, would cause diversity, equity, and inclusion, or DEI programs, and certain college majors relating to DEI to be eliminated or heavily restricted. The legislation phrases such courses as being based on unproven, theoretical, or exploratory content. Texas is debating over harmful laws, debating whether to block transgender kids' access to transition-related healthcare, to classify business that host drag shows as sexually oriented establishments, and limit public school lessons on sexuality and gender identity.
Please remember to be understanding and willing to help others who need it. Bring any concerns about someone being homophobic or transphobic to an authority figure like a teacher or staff member if they don't listen. At this moment, you may be wondering what you can do to help, and knowing what you can do to be an ally is an important step.
You can also try and educate yourself on inclusive terms and become a safe space for the queer people around you. It is never too late to support those around you who need help.